Dependency injection is when you give an object what it needs rather than that object creating or finding it itself. And it can be intimidating because the name is all fancy and there's a few different variations on it, right? Initializer injection, property injection, method injection. Should you use protocols or even property wrappers? There's a lot going on. This video teaches you the core concept on how to use it and what the benefits are. Today's video is sponsored by Squarespace. For our example, we're going to use initializer injection, which you may also hear constructor injection, because why not, right? Dependency injection is not intimidating enough as it is. Let's call the different variations multiple names too. Like, I don't know. Anyway, initializer injection. Let's use the Chipotle app to demonstrate that. Here's our parent view, right? The list of things you can get, you know, burritos, bowls, quesadillas. When you tap on an item like a burrito, it goes to the child view, which shows a list of ingredients for that burrito. So what our child view needs is access to our network manager, which has our API calls, because it needs to pull down that list of ingredients, and it needs access to our bag, which is our order, so when we're adding these ingredients, we can add it to our order. So with dependency injection, instead of the child view, which is the ingredients list, creating its own network manager, creating its own bag object, we have our parent view give the child view the dependencies, right? The network manager and the bag object. And we do that through the initializer. Let's take a look at that in code. Here we have a very basic version of a network manager. You can imagine this is what holds, you know, all your API calls. Again, super simple version for the example, just the function that says fetch ingredients. Here's our bag, right? This has an array of items because we're building that order. And then we have a function called place order. Again, in real life, these two dependencies or objects, the network manager or the bag, will be much more involved, much more complex. But again, keeping it simple for the example. This is what it looks like when our burrito ingredients view model here. Again, this is the child view, the list of ingredients for the burrito. It is creating its own network manager. It's creating its own bag. So this is without dependency injection. And then you can see it uses the network manager to fetch the ingredients and then it uses the bag to place order. With dependency injection, we don't want to create these within the child view. We want the parent view to pass them in. And like I said, we're going to do that through the initializer. So instead of these properties creating new objects itself, we're going to make them of type network manager, get rid of the equal sign, put a colon, get rid of the parentheses for the initializer, put a colon there. So now we just have properties called network manager that are of type network manager and bag that is of type bag. And now we're going to build an initializer to accept values for those objects passed in. So we'll do init. And you can see we get the autocomplete here. Network manager takes in a type of network manager, and a bag takes in a type bag. And then you see self.network manager equals the network manager in the bag that we passed in. So now, anytime we create a burrito ingredients view model, part of the initializer is going to require, hey, give me a network manager, give me a bag. That is us injecting the dependencies, dependency injection. And then you can see we're still using it, network manager fetch ingredients, and then bag place order. Now here's again a quick pseudocode example. I'll paste it in here. Here's the meal category view. As you can see, this would be the parent view that has the burritos, the quesadillas, et cetera. You can see the network manager and bag get created in the parent view. And then again, more kind of pseudocode here, because if you're using SwiftUI, maybe this would be a navigation link to present the child ingredients view, or if you're in UI kit, maybe you're, you know, a destination view controller. So this is not exact code, just to be clear, because it's gonna be different in SwiftUI or UI kit. Didn't want to confuse you. I just wanted to make it super simple so you understood that however you're navigating to that child view, again, the list of ingredients for burrito, this is where you would create the view model for it, right? Burrito ingredients view model, and then you pass in the network manager you created in the bag you were created at the parent view. So again, this is us injecting the dependencies into the child view rather than the child view creating them itself. Now you may be noticing a potential downside of this initializer injection. Now, whether it's property injection, initializer injection, method injection, they all have their pros and cons and use cases. That's above the scope of this, you know, core concept video. But potential downside of this initializer injection, you can see we have two dependencies. And the initializer is not that bad, but imagine if you had 4, 5, 6, 7 dependencies. Okay, now this initializer gets a little unruly. So again, there's pros and cons to each way. Now you may be looking at this child view and say, well, that's a very minor difference. And hey, we even added more code. So isn't this a little more complex? Why are we doing this? What are the benefits of dependency injection? So that's the second part of the interview question if you get asked this, right? They're gonna ask, what is it? And then why would you do it? So the first reason you might do it is to simplify the flow of data. So in this example, where the parent view, the list of meal items, right? The burritos, the quesadilla, is passing in all the information the child needs, right? That's one flow, very easy. Whereas before, where the child view, the ingredients list, it had to create its own network manager, it had to create its own bag. You can see the flow of data is getting a little more messy, and this is a super simple example. Imagine if you had a giant app with tons of views, it turns into a giant spider web. So to help ease the understanding of how data is flowing, you know, dependency injection makes it very linear. The next two benefits kind of go hand in hand. So the first, we'll talk about the separation of concerns. With dependency injection, we're removing the responsibility of the child to create its own dependency. They still need to know how to work with those dependencies, right? They still need to know what to do with the network manager, but it's not their responsibility to create it. That simplifies and compartmentalizes things, which also makes it easier to swap out components, right? If you make a completely new networking layer, you just inject in the new networking layer, which goes hand in hand with improving tests. That's a big thing for dependency injection, because when you try to test the child view, instead of it having to create the network manager, create the bag and all that stuff, you can just inject in a mock version of the network manager and then run your test. So the ability to inject either a mock network layer or the real network layer, and your child knows how to handle it regardless, that allows you to test the child object way easier. Understanding the concept that dependency injection is giving the child object its dependencies or what it needs versus the child object creating it itself, that is the key. And then the other key to answering the interview question is to list off a few of those benefits I just told you. And if you're preparing for iOS dev job interviews, a great way to stand out is to have a beautiful portfolio to showcase your work. And that brings me to today's sponsor, Squarespace. Squarespace is an all-in-one platform to help you get that iOS developer portfolio, blog, or personal website up and running very quickly. Now I know, we're all developers with the skills and the desire to build the web page ourselves, but I would argue there's an opportunity cost to your time. If you're an iOS developer trying to build a great product, a great app, maybe spending a lot of time learning the ins and outs of web development, responsive design, isn't the best way to spend your time. That's why I recommend Squarespace to build that personal website, the blog, your portfolio, or maybe a landing page for your app. They have all kinds of beautiful themes and templates to get you started. They handle all the analytics and the SEO for you. Again, it just saves you so much time so you can get back to doing what you want to do, and that is building iOS apps. So when you're ready to get started, go to squarespace.com to start your free trial. And when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/SeanAllen to get 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain.